Hello everyone and welcome back to the third tutorial. In this tutorial I'm going to teach you how to make different types of backgrounds. Okay, first we're going to start with the most basic thing, the overall background. And we can make that by making a solid by right clicking, go on new and then click on solid. Then you can pick a nice color. I'm going with a light blue-ish. And then click OK. Okay, now we have our overall background. And now we can add some things on there, such as particles. Particles are these little shapes that just fly around the screen. So right click in the composition and make another solid. The color doesn't matter. For the particles, you need a plugin called Particular from Red Giant Trap Code. Now we have this. So we want to click on a designer. If you don't see that, make sure to open this by clicking on the triangle. Here we can change how many particles we want. I'm going with 10. We change the emitter type to sphere and change this to XYZ individual. Make this 2500, 1 and 1. Now we have this. If you want the particles to go down, then you want to drag the position, the 540, you want to drag it up. But if you want the particles to come up, you want to drag it down, like that. So now we have this, and we are going to gravity, and we are going to set it on minus 150 to make it go up, or 150 to make it go down. So now we're going to emitter and then motion, and we are going to set the velocity on 300. Now we're going to particle type to textured polygon colorize and then click on choose sprite. Then this screen will pop up with all of these particles. You can also make custom particles and you can just select one that you want. Now you have all these really small triangles. We're going to set the life to 10 so they stay a little bit longer. We're also gonna make the particle feather 0. Now we can move on to the size and rotation. We want to make the size something that you like. And then make the rotation speed Z something like 0.2. Then we can go to color and click random from gradient. Then we can select a preset. And to change the presets, we can click on these little squares to adjust the colors. We can also drag them around. Okay, if you're done, just click apply. Now we can add the drop shadow effect and change some settings. Okay, now you can select both layers for the particles and the triangle thing with holding control. Then right click and click pre-compose. And of course click on move all attributes in the new composition. Now we have our particles. If you want plexus, you can go to this tutorial. I'll hopefully put a link in the description for this tutorial. Now we are going to go to optical flares. To make optical flares, right click in the composition and make another solid. Then go to here and then apply the optical flares effect. Okay, so now we have this. First we're going to change the position to 960 and 540 so it's in the center. Now we're going to click on options. Now you can delete all these presets. Okay, now we can click on glow and maybe streak if you want. And then click OK. We can change the color by clicking on here and then selecting our color. If we want multiple optical flares, just scroll down and click on black next to render mode and make it transparent. Then you can duplicate the layers with Ctrl D and then you can change the position. Okay, now on to the shapes. You can find the shape tool up here. Hold your left mouse button to see all these different shapes. Hold shift and draw a rectangle. Then click Ctrl, Alt and Home to center the anchor point and then go to align and then click on these two. Now we can click on fill and then remove it. You can adjust the stroke width right here, and you can adjust the color right here as well. If you select the shape layer and press R, you can change the rotation of the shape. You can also animate that if you want. You can do that by clicking on the stopwatch. Now go to the start, click on the shape layer and press S. Then click on the stopwatch and make it 0. Then go to about 2 seconds and then make it bigger until you can't see it anymore. Now we have this shape. Okay, when you're happy with your shape, you can pre-compose the layer. Now we can duplicate the layer and then offset it by a couple frames. Now we can add the gradient ramp effect. Now we can change the colors of the shape. Then select them both, right click them, click on pre-compose and make them 2. Now we can add the echo effect to make them repeat. Make the echo time with seconds about -0.9, and then you have this. Also make the number of echoes like 50. Okay, now we have our shapes background. Now we can add some effects on it. These are some examples. For instance, the drop shadow effect, the turbulent displace effect, and of course the Venetian blinds effect. Okay, now we're going to make a sunburst. So we make it by selecting the star tool and then making a star while holding shift. Click Ctrl Alt Home and make it in the center by clicking these things. Then go to the polystar path 1. Now just copy my settings. Okay, if you have this, select the layer, click on R, click on the stopwatch while holding Alt. Then type time times then something like 100. Then it rotates infinitely. If you're happy, you can pre-compose the whole background. Right click the layer, go to time and then enable time remapping. Let's say that this null is your song and you have the markers on them. Then you go to the next marker, click on this diamond and then repeat that. Select all these little keyframes, press F9 and open the graph editor. Select all of them, click on convert to auto bezier to make them linear and then drag them up a tiny bit. So you have this. And now our background goes faster on the beats. Now for the last thing, we're going to make a transition. Go to the shape tool and then select your shape that you want to use for the transition. Make the fill white, zoom out a bit and then make a really big shape while holding shift. Do Ctrl Alt Home, make it centered and then animate the scale from 0 until it fills the whole screen. Then make it stencil alpha. So now we have this. Okay, that was the tutorial. I hope you liked it. These tutorials take me a lot of time to edit and stuff. So please hit the like button and subscribe. And see you next time. Bye.